Hi, everyone. My name is Satish.
My name is Tachibon.
My name is Tabak.
This section, we will talk about the OpenStack, the hidden feature for the database service. Before we start, I will introduce our company. We are Nipah Cloud based in Thailand, and we use OpenStack to provide infrastructure as a code as a service. Without consulting and managed service, we help our user achieve lower downtime and reduce operation cost, resulting in greater satisfaction. With the power of OpenStack, we have introduced various many solutions to our product. Our main product is Nipah Cloud Space. It is a public cloud that features a self-service portal and now support API. This year, 2024, we launched a new feature, SQL database. It comes with basic features and currently adding more functionality. Today, about agenda, firstly, we will start with a recap of both agenda, about both components and the key feature. Next, we will look into the probe module, how they work and provide example. After that, we will discuss about the internal feature we developed to benefit our user, including the monitoring feature and service recovery feature. We will also demonstrate the tool we use and the concept behind making them work effectively. Let's begin with first. The component of the TOF service include the API connector, task manager, and grant agent. To deliver TOF feature is rely on other OpenStack service, including Nova, Tinder, Grant, Newton, and Swift. The grant agent is key for interacting with the database. It receives message from the message queue and process them inside the TOF instance. For example, when we need to backup or restore database, the get agent will start the appropriate subsystem process to execute the command such as performing the MySQL dump or MySQL import. Currently, the TOF has many features support various database types, lifecycle management such as backup, restore, and upgrade. High availability feature include replication and clustering. Security feature including network isolation and network ACL. Monitoring is achieved by importing log from TOF instance to Swift. There are the features currently support. However, from our perspective, it's missing something of high value that is typically required by the application when using in production. To make TOF a true database as a service, there are some missing features that would make it more usable. One is about monitoring and analytics. It makes users know about their performance when using TOF database. Two is about high availability. Handle about operation tasks like auto failover, auto healing, and auto scale. Three is about ease of use. When using clustering, the cluster endpoint should not require adjustment every time there is a failover or when adding more leaf gun. To add this feature to the TOF, we believe that starting from scratch would be impractical. Instead, we think it's more feasible to build upon ASIC capability and integrate them into a TOF. Leveraging the current architecture and functionality, this approach This approach will allow us to enhance top usability without having review the entire stem from the ground up. The technical challenging for adding feature include the first is time of process must be running inside the top instance to perform certain operation. Two is dynamic configuration. If indication with the another open source is needed, they must support dynamic configuration for indicator. And feature flexibility for some features should be configurable, allow user to enable or disable them as they need. When we start our research and began doing a proof of concept, we found something in the code that we never know existed before. This is the top module management, the top module management. This feature aligns perfectly with the technical challenge we have been discussing, as it allows us to add everything we want into the top service. The purpose of the top module is to help config, apply, activate license when need. Since TOP supports both the open source and the proprietary database, however, we discovered that the module can be used not just for the licensing purpose, but also to implement the new feature that our customer needs. After searching for the document about this feature, we found that the latest version of the TOP document does not cover this feature. It's only mentioned in usually version and early version. My team refers to this as a hidden feature. Next, I will just explain about the TOP module.
The TOP module concept will allow the development of new features. Engineers need to build images where various packets are being installed for users. And they must also author their scripts and declare them within the TOP guest agent. The TOP module is utilized by invoking the TOP API. After that, when a TOP instance is created, and it can notify at the time of creation of the TOP instance or manually request the TOP API. This process enables us to add many features seamlessly. This is an example of thin module that comes with OpenStack code. We send a message to the guest agent and receive the same message in return. Now let's look at how the thin module works. The client sends and requests to the TOP API. Within the message, it proxies the message to the TOP guest agent. The guest agent sends the output to a file inside the TOP instance and leads the output back to the client to the TOP API, which in response to the client request within the message. The step of adding a circuit to the TOP guest agent involves modifying the code within the TOP project. First step, add the desired script file inside the path TOP slash guest agent slash module slash driver. Second step, define in setup.cfg the name and path of the driver you added.
After you add a code, you need to build a new guest agent image and use it for deploy TOP instance. Image form the modified TOP port and then use it with a TOP instance. And then you need to add a driver name to the TOP guest agent config file so that when you run the TOP instance, the guest agent will load the newly added mood driver. And the next is an example of creating and using the pin module, which is a pre-existing driver intro. The pin module is, its functionality is that the message will send in an input to the guest agent, and the guest agent will respond with the same input. In this example, the message sent is hello world. So the first step is to prepare the data, which is to create a module, which will define the input and driver to be used, and will store the data before it is used. Once you want to use the prepared data, you can apply the module that you have created to the drop instance where you want to use it. Processing from this one will be done by the guest agent, and the result from this module will be a hello world output message according to the functionality of the ping driver. The value return can be viewed retrospectively through listing of the module of that instance. It lists information about the module that have applied to that instance, and the instance can have more than one module applied, depending upon user's requirement.
This is the top module right now. There is lack of maintain a version of dependency library by patching the top get agent first before we use. There is only documentation how to use with command line in the usually or early versions. And the last is there is no document how to use the top module via the top API. After we working on it, we now understand how it works, and next we will discuss the feature we are developing using the top module.
IPA has built upon the top module to add feature to the DBAS that we use. One of the SQL search feature of using database is monitoring. What we aim to provide is a way for user to easily and seamlessly enable the monitoring feature on the design database. Before starting with the monitoring feature, it's important to first get to know an open source tool that assists with monitoring. Any background, we use Pocona Monitoring and Management, or PMM. PMM is an open source tool specifically designed for monitoring database. It offers several features, including comprehensive monitoring tools, the ability to configure essential alert, query analysis for optimized application performance, and the capability to perform backup and recovery operation. PMM consists of two main components. The first is the PMM server, which is responsible for receiving and storing data collected from PMM client. This data can be displayed on a dashboard and analyzed for performance. The second component is the PMM client and agent installed on the database server. It continuously queries the necessary data and sends it to the PMM server. Another interesting feature of the PMM server is ability to monitor multiple instance and database seamlessly, including comparing master and replica instance. All of this can be set up and monitored easy and without complexity. In this section, Nipa use the Perf module to assist with the process. When a user enable the modeling feature, the Perf module handle receiving the configuration input for the VM client. It then create a database user for modeling purpose and register the VM client with the VM server according to the provide configuration. In summary, the user process involves just a few steps. First, the user needs to install their own VM server for monitoring and receiving the data from the VM client. Then they apply the module by enabling the monitoring feature we have prepared after that. The user will be able to monitor the database through the PM server they have set up. The advantage is that it's easy and quick to use because the Perf module handle many parts of the process and the PM server provide ready to use dashboard. This means user don't have to spend time setting up and the monitoring system.
The second feature of the database as a service that we can provide database service with company. Our goal is to ensure that every client, whether it is an application or a user, can connect to the database using a stable read line or read only endpoint. That remains consistent regardless of node scaling or failover. This allows clients to avoid the need for reconfiguration, as everything will be managed through the DNS system. We have integrated HashiCorp control to assist with this. Control is particularly powerful in the service recovery, helping to recover track and monitor the health of service within the network. Service recovery will register and maintain a record of every service in the service catalog. The service catalog acts as a single source, allowing our service to query and communicate with each other efficiently. To achieve this, we need to build a new top image that includes a console agent. Additionally, we need to write a top module script to config the console agent for creating service configuration and handle DNS name when promote remote of database. Once we have set up the top module, when we apply the top module via the top API, it will request the top module to config the console client and register the service with the console server. When a client accesses the service endpoint to the DNS name, console will forward the request to the register database. The first scenario, that Nipah Cloud has implemented for the top module with control server is for a standalone database without any select node. In this case, there is only master node and the endpoint provide will be relied endpoint and read-only direct to the master node. The second is for a master select database setup. Here the endpoint provide would be both relied and read-only. The read line would point to the master node, while read only would point to the target node. The third case is failover, which is almost identical to the master select setup described in second scenario. Nothing happens to the read line endpoint and thus it is not modified. This ensures that nothing has to be changed on the client side as far as the database connection configuration goes, and will keep running smoothly. The endpoint provide to user and easy to be used because the car admin has already set up the top module to auto apply. Client can connect to the database to an external endpoint that is publicly exposed or an internal endpoint provided within their own VPC. These endpoints are categorized as relay or relay and are ready for use whether the setup is standalone or master select. Next are conclusion and future plan.
The conclusion, the top module is called the Brighton a long time ago, but it was like all the documentation of the specification. This has required the team to review the actual shortcode to understand the capability of the top module. Based on the user requirement we received, we successfully addressed them by creating a custom module and indicated integrating into the own email, our own email, including both monitoring and service recovery. In the future, the plan is to focus on implementing auto failover by finding a system to detect the service auto instance and handle auto queuing and auto failover. Finally, we aim to enable TOP to work in a multi-AC configuration on our different cloud space platform. And that concludes of the topic, TOP hidden feature for database service. Thank you everyone for joining this session.